Grandpa ripped that hat right off your head. That's when my friend turned around, and this is what he said.
A decent day. That was a difficult day. You know, it felt kind of basic written down on paper, So I wanted the four sets of 10 on the Manta Ray bar squats. The weight really didn't matter. I think I actually put down 1 to 1.5 plates with option for bands, but not really to use bands. And I got here and decided to use the bands and then put 2 plates on there. So, I mean, the weight wasn't hard. It was the reps that I need. So, you know, I knew that muscularly my legs need to be stimulated. I know that my spine doesn't need to be compressed. So that's the direction that I went. And I can't say that I had any spinal discomforts at all. And my legs were pretty toast. Pretty toast. My wife let me borrow this little Chinese watch to hook to my phone. We're doing a little step thing. Some little game thing that we're all doing at our house. And so I thought, well, hey, if you know, I never have my phone in my pocket. I always take it with me and I set it somewhere because things fall out of my pockets. I've got giant pockets and a heavy phone. So I thought I would hook it up to my watch, her watch, and I could just wear that and it's not measuring the steps at all. So I thought it would do that while I was training. But it measured my heart rate, and it's really, really wild because I've been taking my blood pressure a lot with a just, you know, a cheap knockoff blood pressure meter. And it's ran, you know, the top number has been like 135. The bottom number has been like 75. But it's been showing my heart rate at like 95 or better, you know, resting heart rate. And then I go and spend 45 minutes on the rowing machine and get off, and my resting heart rate's like 105. Not resting, but my heart rate, the moment that I get off the machine, I'm covered with sweat. So I'm guessing that that little cheap thing is way off, because this is showing that my heart rate, I think once it hit like 87, but most of the time it was in the 70s, like 71. So knocked out those squats. My legs were shaky. I had it in the plan to knock out the front squats. And you know, guys, I really want something that is kind of dialed into an Atlas Stone weight for me. So that's somewhere around the 300 pound mark, 300 to 330. I haven't done front squats in a while. So I left those blue bands on there. Worked up to, I think I nailed 306. The 2 plates felt really easy. Felt I had a really, really good position. My elbows were in front of the bar. My chest was up, really good posture. That felt great. So I added the Duffin 35 on the side and a collar. I think that worked out to be 306 plus the bands, and it felt pretty solid. But at that point when I racked it, everything kind of got a little bit blurry, a little bit fuzzy. Wanted to get moving. Set up the isometric deadlift stations, and that was when, as I mentioned earlier, setting them up, I began like blacking out. So I don't know what's going on. I took my massage gun and went across my clavicles and my chest and my pecs, across my traps. I've got some really bad tightness in my traps today as well. And as I began doing that, actually everything began to clear up. So I began drilling all down the grill, all across the clavicle collarbone, all the way down the pecs. Same on the other side, across the traps. And everything began to clear up. So I sent my wife a message, hey, things are getting blurry. I'm going to take an extra 15, 20 minutes on deadlifts today. But I went back and forth, low pin. This was, I don't know what the weight was. It was 3 plates, but one of them is it's a 50-pound bar. The first plate was a 55-pound bumper, and then I've got some sort of weighted fit, this collar on the ends. I think these add like 5.5 total. So whatever that was, it doesn't really matter. And I was explosive. I was picking up the rack. The rack is moved across the room. And I've got a ton of chains holding this rack down. A ton of chains and a ton of plates holding the rack down. And it's not a light rack either. So what I did notice is that I have a flat or rounded back on the isometrics. I picked this up a couple weeks ago. I don't know if you guys are picking this up. But I picked it up on the isometrics, and the isometrics are a great lift to make assessments, especially if you have a really smart training partner, and or you're videoing everything and you're really good at assessing yourself. So my back, even though it's flat, which is totally acceptable, is not arched, which is where I tend to create my most torque. So, and I create that torque through the hamstrings whenever I get a hard arch in my back, or at least some kind of arch in my back. At times I've thought that that arch contributed to hamstring pulls, but what I think happens is having a flat-ish back and then starting the deadlift, I end up losing that flattish back just a hair, round forward just a hair, and that puts the bar down deeper while my hips are higher and in a bad position, my body's in a bad position, and then pop goes the hamstring. So that's what I'm thinking. So on my last round, I emphasized trying to gain a little more of an arch. I haven't watched that video yet, so we'll see what happens. Nothing drastic, I just need a little bit more arch. That way I feel like I can use a little more legs and a little more hamstrings and a little more tightness through the midsection. Over here to the deadlifts, I don't know how long I waited between the two. It felt like about 15 seconds. I wanted it to be about a minute and a half to 2 minutes at the most. I'll see on the video. It was the same song. So I think it was 415, 416 over here plus 105 in chains. I know that getting a triple should total out to a 600 pound deadlift. I think getting that wouldn't be correct. Either way, I had an option. I wanted to get three reps with the weight that was on here because that would pretty much assure me a 600 pound deadlift because I know me and I know how my percents and my sets and reps wave and how they feel. But I also knew it was totally acceptable just to pull a single and think to myself, yeah, I had two more, man. I had three, so therefore I could still pull 600. So it felt solid. I pulled three. I have to see it on video. I think I had a slightly better arch this time. I feel like I had a decent position at least on the first one, but we'll have to see. Does that mean for sure I can pull six? No. Everything could go wrong at the start. I don't know, because it's still bar and chain weight. But, you know, usually whatever I've done with chains, as long as it's not like 200 pounds of chains or something. And this is getting close to the limit of, hey, we got way too much chain on the bar for this to be accurate. But usually if I can pull it with chains, I can pull it with straight weight. So my head is clearing. I had some other stuff down, some calves, abs, lats, and things like that. I'm not going to risk it. I'm not. So I'm going to take my butt home, and then I'll play around with abs and then do some rower tonight. Going to get outside and play with the kids before everybody goes to bed and goof off in the dirt, make all the neighbors upset by being loud late at night. But hey, we're on Easter holidays, bro, Chacho. Easter holidays. Plan is to rest and get back here on Friday for a little bit of presticles. I have kind of a new plan, kind of a shift in some things that I want to do I think will actually benefit me in the medium and long run on my log press. So we'll wait and see. New stuff coming on Friday, and already excited to be here on the weekend. So you guys have a great one. See you Friday.